And my answer is yes, you should run automated tests in production. No, you don't need to run every single test case that you have. So when it comes to creating automation for production, you need to think about doing a sanity for your features that you're releasing. It's not worth it going through everything because you've already validated the functionality in probably 2, 3, 4 environments before you went to production. So you don't want to also pollute the database in production unless you have some special users or like some special way of keeping track of what you're doing and cleaning up after yourself. Usually cleans up in production are very, very tricky and sensitive. So you probably don't want to mess production up very, very, you know, like a lot. Usually, if, especially if you're working on, you know, high volume, high transaction volume types of products, you will have some kind of monitoring in place because you need to have your machines available to the customers all the time. You can't really have any downtimes. So for that, monitoring is added in place by DevOps or developers, but the monitoring only helps so much. So it mostly checks for, you know, is the server up? Is the server responding to the pings? They're not checking whether the functionality still works. So that's where you come in with your automated tests. That is why we need automated tests in production. First of all, we need to validate every release that is going out, right? We need to validate that what we are releasing is working in production. Even if it was working in the previous environment where you tested it, it doesn't guarantee that it's going to work in production. So it's really, really good to have a sanity, which you can run, you know, frequently, maybe on a daily basis, maybe hourly, depends on what you're doing. But you do need to have automation in production because you do need to make sure that customers will not report that the site is down. You do that yourself way earlier and fix it by the time the customers get to your site. Does automation uncover bugs? Yes. Now, the thing is, when you create your automation code, unless you're doing AI or something like that, you create a sequence of lines of code that execute, or you have, you know, your steps in your codeless automation tools. These are basically a sequence of things that are executed, right? So you are doing something, you're clicking on a button, you're checking for some response, you're doing your stuff. You can uncover bugs in the code that you wrote. So if the sequence of your steps that was previously working is not working anymore because maybe, let's say, if it's the UI, a new pop-up appeared and you wanted to click on something and the pop-up is in the way, the test is going to say, oh, I cannot click on the button because there is a pop-up there. So this is how you catch the bug. It will not catch, for example, a bug when something that you're not testing has changed. It will only report on what you told it to report on, right? So the checks that you put in place will tell you if something is not working anymore in your own test, not in anything else for which you're not testing. It cannot detect anything around that because it doesn't have, you know, some kind of you know, intelligence to tell you something else is not working. So automation does uncover bugs in your features, especially if, let's say, somebody else changed something that is affecting your features. You know, many times when you're going to production, for example, many teams are going at the same time. And maybe some of the code that somebody else is releasing wasn't for some reason tested in a previous environment. When you're running your test in production, you will see that there is a change, that your feature is not working as expected because of somebody else's change. Maybe some other teams changed, or maybe someone in your team changed something without letting you know. So your tests can uncover bugs as long as, you know, the bugs are in the feature that you were actually testing. I hope this makes sense.